Hello everyone. Today I'm going to be sharing another video of why these are probably some of my most favorite cookie cutters. Now you've probably seen me use this several times before, and I'm particularly using these two. Now remember, when I say these two, it's because it's concentric, so it's obviously the green one is bigger, and this is the next size. So what I've done is rolled out, made a slab and then cut out two such circles using these cookie cutters. Obviously the green one is this and the red one is this, and I've just laid it out flat here. This is going to be familiar to you because this is something that I have already uploaded before, but this is just making it a little bit more functional. Let's just see how we do that. We go through the same process, we smoothen it and the usual set of stuff. Choose to design it, that's up to you, or you want to leave it plain, that too works perfectly fine. I might just add something very, very basic, a very basic design actually. I might not do I probably wouldn't do like too much of heavy work on it, so I might just do very simple, maybe checks. You can use a scale for this if you want to get like equal measurements. I have a little, you've seen me use this before. This is just a simple coffee stirrer. So I might just add like random designs. Okay, that's it. Now let's just see what's going to happen to this. You've seen this before, my heavy duty sponge. Place it as centrally possible. Give it a nice press. Keep this aside. This is the smaller one. This one though, I'm going to actually put it the other way around. Press it down. Now I have one piece which is like this, and the other one which is obviously like this. I have this little, I basically use this jhumka mold, and I've used this particular size in order to just take out this. Just like a small semicircular ball, that's all. I would typically score this. You can score it using a knife, a fettling knife, an X-Acto, a scratcher tool, anything you want. And I would also score the top of this. I think you probably have already started guessing on what this is going to be. And I have some slip here. Apply generously on both the pieces and there. Give it a gentle press, making sure it's nice and firm. Now comes the part of attaching it. I might just take away a little bit off the excess from the sides. That's just the slip. I'll use just a, you can use anything like a finishing tool or a sculpting tool, anything you want, just to, attach these. Make sure it's nice and firm. The other method is also just taking a small thin coil of clay, putting it around and then just attaching the sides. Use the finishing tool. Give it a nice, neat finish like that. I might just fill in a little bit of the design which kind of got lost in that. You have this little lid and something that goes on top of this. You can maybe make use of this as a kumkum bowl, something that you can store, maybe kumkum or haldi, anything. Just make sure you put this in, and it's a really, really cute thing. It's just that it's really wet right now, so it's better that you just leave it, let it dry a little bit. But this is it. I think this is really, really nice, especially with Shankranti coming up. I think this might be this is appropriate probably for your a puja room. And by the way, for those who don't know, Shankranti is actually a festival celebrated across India. And so this would probably make for a perfect gift. And also, even if you have to basically store some haldi and kumkum or just a few little things inside, I think this would really do the job. I think it's a nice little project, and I think it's something that people, I think even kids might probably enjoy doing this. This knob, it's just optional. If you don't want the knob, you can, leave the knob and probably just add something else to it, or leave it plain, and just make use of it this way. So I really hope you like the video, everyone. If yes, then please like the video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. Thank you.